And welcome everybody here in Twitch chat and also on YouTube if you're watching in the future for our next deck, which is going to be Rakdos Burn. We played this just a few days ago and I really enjoyed playing it. I think we went 3-2, which is, you know, pretty respectable record. And I thought it was a pretty fun deck to play, and so I want to try it again. You know, I'm still not sold on like our sideboard, because you know, we just built the deck for the last stream, and so I've switched up a few things in the sideboard, most notably adding in some Ritual of Soots for the Soul Tie matchup when they have like their Wild Growth Walkers and a bunch of creatures and stuff. Got some Ritual of Soots there. And having a Banefire and some Direfleet Daredevils also. Banefire for control, Daredevil for, I don't know, other red decks and stuff. I don't know. We may have like too much removal and everything. I don't really know. We're even though we're a burn deck, we're basically a control deck here. We use Swordpoint Diplomacy, Light Up the Stage, Risk Factor for our card advantage, and just kind of just gain like just a lot of card advantage with those, and you know, have enough burn spells to kill the opponent eventually. The one change I'm trying in the main deck is I'm taking out one Light Up the Stage for an Angrath in the main deck, and we'll see how that works out for us. That's the one change in the main that trying it out. So we're playing burn control. So you know, let's kind of get to the games and see how it works this time with our Pestilent Spirit burn control deck. Okay, so yeah, this was the deck you were referring to as impressive, because the last time you saw it, it felt really good. Okay. Yeah, there's certainly something here. We have a deck filled with good cards, you know, so we certainly have something there. Okay, we had a song with the lyrics, "I'm not dead yet," yesterday. That's a lot of lightning strikes. We'll keep this against a six card hand on the draw. I'm not sure if there's a way to find a song by just searching for those lyrics. Carnival is perfect for next turn against the Land War Elf. Uh-oh, Raptor Hatchling. That's a problem. All my things do damage. I guess they're just gonna have this like 1/1 that I'm never gonna deal with. All right, deck, where are these lands at? Yeah, maybe that's what you can do. Google search like that lyric and kind of go through the playlist, I guess. There's my playlist, 650 songs. But yeah, that I would think that "I'm not dead yet" is a hard lyric to Google. Yeah, we can Angrath -3 this Raptor eventually. Or we could just also just ignore it. I'll probably just ignore it, because even just Angrath ticking up, I mean, it's just a 1/1. It's going to kill us in 18 turns. I think I could just ignore that thing. If only Death Touch worked on players, right? I'd like the Death Touch Ajani, please. They're not even attacking with it. Burn spell, you. It's called Infect. Basically. Bzzz. Think this is a dinosaur precon? It certainly could be. And next turn, we should be able to strike them from the record. Rakdos burn, getting done. It's a lot faster than the Esper taken turns we were playing earlier. Whole lot faster there. All right, as far as sideboarding goes, I don't know if I wanted really do very much. We didn't see too much. I guess they're probably playing like Steel Leaf Champion. If they have like that enchantment that like that they have like large creatures, maybe I want some like lava coils. Or Ritual of Suts, things like that. I gave him so many turns, though. Oh, there you go. You figured it out. Incubus undefeated. Awesome. There you go. Good job, Norm. So I kind of want Lava Coil. I kind of want Daredevil because they play Lightning Strike. I kind of want Ritual of Suts. Those are three cards that I kind of want. I'm not sure if I want them enough to put them in the deck, though. I don't want them that much to put them in the deck, but we'll see what else they have. They could certainly have like some really big dinosaurs that kill me really quickly, and I'll have to adjust for game three. We'll see. No Land War Elf, which is what I want them to play. I was hoping they would play Land War Elf. So if I just play Swordpoint Diplomacy on turn 3 before anything else, then our opponent can just give us a lot of cards and then we have to move to discard. So let's just go ahead and risk factor here. And then I can untap in Diplomacy. Yeah, our opening did not have enough Lightning Strikes. We got one so far now, though. So we have six cards in hand right now. Did they give us all of the cards? Alright, so we're gonna have to just go to discard. We'll just play this, shock them. Oh, no, we don't, because that's seven. Yeah, because we went up to nine, now seven. Perfect. Yeah, saving Carnage, we could, you know, of course there we didn't have the mana, but yeah, Carnaging the opponent's certainly going to be an option for later. Angrath.
Ever seen water burn? You will.
Ever seen water burn?
No fire, no steam. I mean,
does that count like boiling water from a mac and cheese? Does that count as water burning? Whoa, that thing's gonna kill me quickly. That thing's gonna kill me quickly.
No fire.
I mean, our opponent's certainly dead right now, but, well, they're not certainly dead. They're probably dead. So now we're going to go ahead and Carnage. So they get two draw steps. What do they got? Ooh. Big trample dino. I think it's trample, right? Yeah. Just reality smasher dinosaur. Wait. Yeah, we're good. Okay. Let's just steal their dino.
Your crew for my freedom? A fair price.
I was thinking about just like Pestilent Spirit and then Carnival to kill, to do one to the, or like, I guess I'd have to skewer for, whatever. Lots of ways to end the game there. Don't know what the coolest line was, but taking their dinosaur was kind of cool. I don't kill people with charging monstrosaurs too often. Burn. Yeah, I've been really happy with Pestilent Spirit in the deck, which is why I have it. The very first time I tried the deck, so this is my third time now trying the deck. The very first time I just had the Pestilent Spirit and the Carnival in the sideboard, and I brought him in every single matchup. And I really liked him. And so now I am trying the main deck. All right, so yeah, doing the Sovereign's Bite here because instead of playing Lava Runner, because next turn I can still just go Lava Runner plus Bite, and then they both have haste. Could just shock the Branch Walker, make him chump block. All right, they're down to 10. We obviously cannot beat a Wild Growth Walker at all. We don't that. Ooh. Okay. Pay two life.
No one knows the wilds like I do.
Oh no. Oh yes. That was a close one. All right, the old turn four kill. So this is a matchup that I was thinking about kind of changing the deck up some. So like if I play Ritual of Soots here and Angraths. Maybe not the Angraths. Do you like the repeated damage? You like Cannonade here? See, I think I want Ritual of Six. I want to make sure to kill like the bigger things. Yeah, we are playing the Light 'em Up song. Isn't this it? Yeah, we are a control deck that just can also kill our opponent quickly at times. We got a very, very aggressive hand. Yep. Light aim up. This is 64 here. So I take out the two skewers. Maybe we go two Angrath. And I do like Pestilent Spirit in this matchup. You know, like being able to kill their things. But maybe we don't need all four. Let me go three. Light them up. Not the best hand. Oh, I think Sovereign's Bite was the card that I was thinking about taking out in this matchup. I think that's the card I was thinking about taking out. Like, maybe I want... Because I just don't... Yeah, Coil certainly seems like a pretty decent card, but I don't really know where to fit it. And maybe that's what I do. Maybe I kind of take out Sovereign's Bite and light up the stages. And I could go Coil and... Theater. I'm not sure. I expect they sideboarded out Midnight Reaper in a matchup against a deck with all those burn spells like we had. I don't think Midnight Reaper is going to be in their deck anymore. We've drawn every light up. Well, that's not a very good light up stage. That goes one of our ritual upsets. So now our opponent just knows not to play a creature. Never getting that ritual set. I'm not gonna cast this light up, so I'd be worried about, you know, exiling too many spells here. Death Touch. Target player loses life with Death Touch. Come on, that's supposed to kill him. Why does that not kill the opponent? Death Touch. Yeah, I thought that was going to win the game, right? I did too. Right, cancel. Swamp, swamp. Jaya is immune to Death Touch. Okay, I gotta transform the opponent into a creature first. I guess they're just sitting there with, like, all removal? Let's do Carnage. Let's make them discard two. Yeah, there goes a removal spell and a land. No! I don't want to see Krasis. Alright, let's draw, like... Ugh, not that. We need to get our... Where's our risk factors and Swordpoint Diplomacies? We need to find one of those seven cards, a Diplomacy or a Risk Factor. Pestilent Spirit wouldn't be so bad either. Or Angrath. I wouldn't mind either of those. Another land? Boo. So I'm playing 23 lands in this deck. So we have seen 10 of our 23. So there are... Yeah, none of those are lands. So there's 13 more lands in the last 38.
Would you like balance? Comes.
Yeah, Angrath would be real good. Steal this Krasis, hit him for five. That's a huge problem. Man. We are flooding out.
I've seen things that would break someone like you.
If we play Lava Coils, take out Bite and Light Up. Play this other Angrath. Play some Theaters. And Skewer. I'm kind of worried about, like, without the Sovereign's Bite also, I'm kind of worried about the Light Up, like, actually having Spectacle for Light Up the stage. Now, I don't want Banefire in this matchup. And yeah, we'll get the other Pestilent Spear back in. Ugh. What happened to all those lands we just had? I mean, we need to draw two lands, but if we do draw two lands, this hand's pretty good with, like, the sword points and risk factors. Especially the sword points really help us go through the deck. All right, that's good. Good sign. Only need to draw one more land. And then sword point will help us hit more land drops. And then once we have a lot more land drops, then we get to start casting risk factors. Pretty efficiently. We'll have a whole, you know, we'll have a lot more land. So land, did not get there. Because then, yeah, we'll have like the extra mana that we can cast multiple risk factors in turn. Come on, deck, let's get this third land. Not another three mana spell. Last game, all we needed was like one sword point or one risk factor. This game, all we need is a third land. Oh my gosh. Yep, the classic. All lands, no lands. Classic way to lose. Now we're in trouble.
The wilds are my shield.
Yeah, we had a good amount of time and everything if we would have just gotten this before. See, now we have just so many cards in hand, our opponent just lets us just draw all the cards, then we have to just go to discard. We just have too many cards in hand now. So we're just gonna throw out the spirit here.
No one knows the wilds like I do.
Well, that sucked. Certainly risk, you know, I kept a one lander, certainly risky. We're one lander where I need to hit a third land drop. We had a scry though, because we were on six. The second game, honestly, was more disappointing than that game. The second game of, with us only having 23 lands in the deck and us just hitting like 10 land drops and not finding anything else, especially for us casting all those Light of the Stages. And like that last Light of the Stage being land. And then it was, you know, land afterwards. That game was more disappointing to me than that third game. So this hand looks pretty good on the play here. Do I want to skewer the Land of War Elf? Or just cast Bite? The way that this can be a problem is if our opponent had Wild Growth Walker here on turn two, and then I don't have a skewer anymore for it. That's where that's the biggest problem. So I attacked there where if our opponent blocked, we would cast Risk Factor, so the Lava Runner would trade with the Growth Chamber Guardian. You know, so they didn't block, so we got to play Pestilent Spirit after getting that point of damage in. Which every point is important. Pestilent Spirit hasn't been so good for us, with our opponents just had like removal, where it's just been eating removal basically. So casting the Sovereign's Bites before combat because I want the Lava Runner to be a 2/2, so you know, get that extra point of damage in, of course. Hey Eddie. So we'll see if we can get these last 10 points of damage in. In case they want to give us the three cards, I'm casting this main phase, because if they give us the three cards, we get to hit land drops. And, you know, we can't attack into, we can't attack our 2/2 into a 4/4. All right, let's finish up the YouTube video for Bant Angels. Demanding Dragon. I will sacrifice this creature. Glad I sacrificed that creature. Opponent is almost killing us. Close game. Remember how we got like that 1 point of damage in earlier? With like the 1-2? Getting that 1 point in? So barely got there. So they're a red-green deck with big dragonies. Kind of like what I got going on here, honestly. Yeah, let's just keep this. I could see, like, not playing Lava Runners. Potentially, just taking those out completely on the draw here against the creature deck and just adding in removal there. Man, Carnival has been just really impressive. That's like the one of my favorite cards in the deck. Maybe my favorite. Yeah, I've been happy with the Gilgate in the deck. Black mana can be a little bit of a struggle. Or enough red if you're trying to chain together like Light at the Stage and like burn spells and stuff. I've been happy with the one Gilgate. I think it's pretty big. It's not small. Is an instant, right? Yeah. Okay. Deck, we need some more spells. Our opponent's still at 11. They still have a lot of life. And our life's going down quickly. All right, they're down to 8.
Risk factor would be a good draw.
We kind of need this turn. Am I chumping the Null Hide? I should probably just chump the Null Hide here. If I do, next turn we're taking... Yeah, let's just jump here. Yeah. Well. So that's... So that's 15. Oh, I shouldn't play the land because of risk factor. I need to keep that land in hand. I was thinking of, like, you know, expanding the lands, but I need to keep that land in hand. Yeah, I should get that land in hand. Taro getting that Twitch Prime stuff for the third month in a row. Welcome back. Thank you so much for continuing that hype. Oh, man. In this game, we have lost a lot of subs, though. Man, we're going... it's telling me we're 119 away now. But that's sub number 8 on the day. Must have had a lot of subscribers a month ago, because they have gone... far down, which happens with, like, you know, Twitch Prime sub running out and everything. C versus. No, S versus. Subversus. There we go. Subversus. Welcome. All right, so Lava Coils against Rekindling Phoenix are good. I've seen Phoenix. Null Hide is, of course, a pretty big problem. The problem with going 21-22, you don't always hit three lands, and you really need three lands to get going. You got to hit to the third land drop, and we usually have, like, the card advantage. But it's just games like that where you just draw all lands and you don't draw your card advantage. You know, we didn't draw any sword points, light up the stages, risk factors. That's tough. It's tough when you draw none of those cards. I certainly see the Angrath winning the game for us. It's obviously not good against Null Hide, obviously. But I could see us getting to the point where we need to steal a creature. Like, they play, like, all these big creatures. I could certainly see us getting to the point of, like, having an Angrath steal a creature being pretty important for us. So we got a risk factor. That should probably deal, like, 8 damage to the opponent. Given their creature's haste, that is rough. and that just can enter with a counter. I can't, like, you know, I can't respond to that with a shock or anything. It's not a trigger that goes on the stack. So yeah, Growth Chamber Guardian's an awesome card here. Hey, Naga. Let's see. I like this kind of deck. What do you think about mixing to Grixis to add Terramander and draw mechanics? That could certainly be a thing. Terramander is a pretty good... pretty good card. So if I could cast double shock and save my Lava Runner. I don't think that's worth it. I think we're just kind of going upstairs. They're down to 7. We just need to draw a Lightning Strike or a Sovereign's Bite. That'll do. And Burn Deck does its thing. Boom.
Always had it. Oh.
Good old Burn Deck. So that's the thing, is like our deck is capable of really quick kills, as we've seen a couple of these times. But then we also have like a kind of good late game also. With all of our extra card stuff. But the Pestilent Spirits haven't been working out as well with us not having other creatures. Maybe we just don't play Pestilent Spirits and just play more removal there. You know? Maybe this should just have like some Sweepers main deck or something. So, shock time. Playing against another Land War Elf deck. Drover of the Mighty. Just want to keep the opponent... I just want to slow him down, you know? I want to be able to hopefully get in with these Lava Runners one more time. Wow. Fiery Cannonade? What kind of deck plays Drover of the Mighty, Land War Elf, and Fiery Cannonade? Like, who does that? Like, what even is that? All right, the opponent's just going down to 2. We just gotta draw one more burn spell. Or a land. We got one more turn. Boom. Yeah, that Fiery Cannonade was rough. All right, so another Dino deck. They're playing Fiery Cannonade? They're probably not taking out Fiery Cannonade, I don't think. So if we take out Pestilent Spirit, we can play like some Ritual of Soots, some Coils. The thing is we have like 4/5s. Maybe an Eldest Reborn? Nah, it's gotta be too slow, right? I don't know. What if we just do this? Just take out Angrath for a Lava Coil. We could out cannonade our opponent. No, I want a Ritual of Soot. Let's play a Soot. All right, our curves, you know, like, we have just tons and tons of three drops in our deck. So I'm keeping this. With all the three drops we have. Just hope, you know, we start drawing those. I own a lot of ties. Maybe 70. I don't know. 80. Lava Runner, you ain't doing nothing. Good hand for the opponent. This is where we need Pestilent Spirit. We need Pestilent Spirit to have, like, Shock be able to kill the opponent's Riptide Raptor. With them missing the land drop here, I'm going to go ahead and kill the Land War Elf. Keep them from... Keep them from casting like a 5 drop the next turn. So light up the stage got us a little bit closer through the deck. Risk factor is a good one. They're at 6. Sack a Lava Runner to do 2. I'm down to 4. Alright, how are we getting another 4 points of damage across? That's the main question. Not with another land. I have all these mana creatures that I just want to kill. What if I do play my own Fiery Cannonade? I don't necessarily love any option for this last slot. Don't really love any of them. Hey, Night Owl. I have my ties set up. I have a large rack on the back of my bathroom door that has like 5 sections, and I have a bunch of ties on each section. And yeah, each section holds like, you know, 20 ties or so. Yeah, full Windsor is my go-to knot. That's the knot that I use. Bicolor. Yeah. Basically in Wooburg order almost, but it's like I have whites, blacks, like reds and pinks, like that kind of stuff. I have purples. Just gotta slow them down. And blues. So, purples, blues, blacks, whites, and reds. Those are like the main color combos. So I'm gonna shock and light up. Or just risk factor. I think I just want a risk factor. I'm a little worried about going shock light up and not playing the other cards. Now shock light up? Now I'll just risk factor again. Well, let's hopefully find like a lightning strike and kill that thing. There's a lightning strike that can kill that thing. Question is if I'm doing anything else. Like, I kind of want to be greedy and go shock plus light up the stage and try to hit a land drop, honestly. I'm going to be really greedy here. There we go.
Beasts, you can't
like our opponent
stop
playing Vivian.
Nature.
That's a pretty slow card. Reggie. I don't think I really even need to Pestilent Spirit, honestly. Just don't think I need to at this point in the game. Sure, we lose a card, but Sword Point Diplomacy gets us so many cards. Yeah, I'm just going to Sword Point. Because again, Sword Point helps us hit more land drops. You know, like with the Sword Points and risk factors, we need to be able to, you know, our bottleneck is mana and being able to cast as many things as possible. That's our bottleneck. So anything that can reduce the pressure on that bottleneck, which Sword Point Diplomacy does by getting us extra lands, that's what we want. So now next turn we get to double spell, we get to like double risk factor next turn, or sword point plus risk factor. Because we need to kill our opponent, not next turn, but the turn after. They certainly need to be dead. Because I don't think they're going to have enough haste
Come
to deal
to me.
An extra 10. Next turn, like another alpha is another 7. I mean, I guess if they have alpha plus 2 mana 3 power dino. So risk factor is just a draw 3. Mm-hmm. The lava runners are good blockers. So I could play lava runner, and go block, block. Or I can also just risk factor and draw three. Guess I'm just going to risk factor because he's my mana better. Don't think my opponent can kill us here. But we have the lightning strike just in case we need it. Yeah, so that's another 7. That's 14. They could have like the give your attacking creature plus 4 plus 2 card. That would kill us. Collision would kill us. All right, no land drop though. They need another land for that. I don't know why they just attacked out, because they just know they're dead now to just let me playing Lava Runner, Lightning Strike. That's just like, why would they attack out when they just put themselves dead? Carnage. Make him discard 2.
Ugh. 3-1 for Rakdos Burn.
Just getting stuck on lands. You know, us having like that all land, no land against Sultai. That's our one loss so far. Yeah, it makes them discard before he can lose. Yep. Yeah, you have to finish resolving the card. And they decided not to discard. They just decided to hit the concede button. But that's why it went to our opponent having 0 life, and it wasn't saying that I won yet, because the opponent has to choose cards to discard first. Let's just keep the shock in hand. Carries over to the next game. Keeping the shock in hand because of the Pestilent Spirit. Don't need it immediately or anything. Gilgate. Gates is certainly pretty tough. Gates can gain a whole lot of life if they're playing, you know, like the white gates with like the gain life creature. Can't you ever just resolve half of a card effect? I don't think so. I mean, I think you just have to keep resolving the rest, like all the cards. Oh my gosh. Revitalize. Opponent. Super rude. Super hecka rude. Revitalizing. Ugh. So much life gain. I don't know if I want to play another Pestilent Spirit out. I kind of assume our opponent has a sweeper. Death Touch. Alright, so never mind. Now we'll play the other Spirit. That was a smart play by the opponent, though, to make sure that my Lightning Strike didn't have Death Touch anymore. So it didn't kill them. More reclamations. So they can cast Nexus of Fate this turn if they would like to. Looks like they may have another explosion. Explosion for 6, for 7. That's just messed up. 5 lands, you get to explosion for 7. It's so messed up. They want to gain that extra 6 life. 9 life. We'd have a chance. Hey, Sculpted Mine. Yeah, you can play Nexus in best of 3. Yeah, so our opponent's playing Nexus. We were playing Nexus earlier in our Esper Taking Turns deck. I actually don't mind Nexus as much. Wilderness Reclamation I really don't like. I prefer Nexus to Wilderness Reclamation out of those two. Yeah, it doesn't matter that our opponent tapped wrong land. They just have all these cards. What am I going to be doing in the sideboard here? Not sure if I'm going to be able to win this matchup with how much life gain they have. I have. So I'm certainly going to be bringing another Angraths. Does Direfleet Daredevil really do anything? Actually, pretty surprised they just let me draw. Man, we are so close to killing the opponent. I could do 9 damage right here with Carnage, Skewer, Skewer. And they're at 10. That other Plaza of Harmony. Wow. Yeah, maybe they take the risk factor here. They didn't take it last time. Oh! Is that it? Is that it? Wow. Wow. Did not think we were winning that game. Banefire, Theater of Horrors, Angraths. Okay, we have some things. Yeah, Archway Angels. Yeah, that's going to be hard. Yeah, Archway Angel is like the... It's going to be the hard one. Hey, what's up, Hawkeye? You want to come up here? Meow. The opponent took 4 from Risk Factor, and then 3 from Skewer, 3 from other Skewer. I think I'm going to take out the Pestilent Spirits, them having a lot of removal and everything. Which makes Carnival worse. Oh, we'll play 1 Pestilent Spirit. I like having a lot of lands in our hands, as we've seen before, but this hand's not going to win. Well, I don't know. So we're drawing into... Actually, maybe I'll just keep this. Because 4 Risk Factor, 3 Sword Point, 3 Light Up the Stage, 2 Theater of Horrors, 3 Angraths. We draw any, like, those are cards, like, that's a lot of our deck that are, like, good draws here. Let's see. There we go. This is Hawkeye. The kitty cat. Casting this first to get the power on the Lava Runner. Real good negate there for the opponent. Hoping they don't have another negate for this Angrath. Angrath's going to need to do some work. Please don't counter. Please don't counter. Good job, Hawkeye. They didn't counter. Way to go.
You're just fuel for the fires of freedom, Kerr.
Hawkeye's like, wow, they didn't counter?
No fire. Look at that. No steel.
Look how crazy that is. This Angrath's on the battlefield. Yeah, you can go say hi to him.
No fire, no steel.
Angrath can win this one. To keep on rowing for. Revitalize. Rude.
No fire, no steel.
And of course, saving the lightning strike for whenever they're tapped out. No need to cast it right away. Yes, yeah, so far they've discarded a couple explosions. That's definitely good for us. And a reliquary tower. It feels like they have another explosion if they're willing to discard the other ones, considering they have Wilderness Reclamation. The opponent expects to win by taking all the turns, casting like a big Hydroid Krasis, and taking extra turns. Keeping this land in hand for risk factor, you know, now we have six mana, and we can double cast a risk factor. At five, could not. And wanted to play the land. Like, the reason to play the land is Banefire. But yeah, we have Angrath ult next turn. So opponent needs to find an answer here. Is that it? No answer? Angrath Ultimate?
I'll die standing before I live kneeling.
Woo! Beat the Nexus deck. No Archway Angel to be found. Good job, Hawkeye. 4-1. Final boss. Yeah, our opponent actually let us Angrath ult. Okay, you're in the way, Hawkeye. I need to get some final boss music. We are 2-0 against the final bosses so far today. We go 3-3 on final bosses. Dun, dun, dun. Let's just try it. Oh no, regular burn. Regular burn. Mono red aggro. Sovereign's Bite is a good card in this matchup. But I don't have any removal right now. And removal is key to killing like the damage threats over time. Thanks, Nagashi. Yeah, this is the song whenever you have a boss battle in Final Fantasy VII. Static Field is just pretty slow and just not a great card. Before RNA came out, I had, you know, this deck had electrostatic fields in it, but risk factor. Certainly thought they would just take the four, so we get to light up the stage and double land. Well, clear off two lands, I guess. Oh no, Demanding Dragon. That's a huge problem. That's just such a big clock. We're actually looking okay, like not like amazing or anything, but okay until Demanding Dragon. That thing just basically 5 power haste. Yeah, I'm still staying pretty fit. A little cheeky. So Daredevil for their burn spells. Trimming some Pestilent Spirits. This is not a matchup for Pestilent Spirit, except for against Demanding Dragon. Maybe I'll just keep one in to try to be able to kill a dragon. Man, demanding dragon's gonna be a tough one to beat. Mono red we're okay against. We're not like amazing against. It's a pretty 50-50 matchup. The Sovereign's bites are really important for us. But demanding dragon in particular, that's gonna kind of move the needle some. Lava Runner, get to going. Dang, the opponent blocked. Let's light up the stage. Lava runners running through some lava upstairs. We're looking good until our opponent plays Demanding Dragon. Then we won't be looking so good anymore. Carnival's pretty nice. I mean, both parts of this are pretty nice. I guess I'm just gonna Carnage. Yeah, let's just Carnage. Take their last two cards. I could, you know, Carnival and deal the one to the Firebrand and one to them, so then they can't block. Put them down to 11, hit them for 4 with the Lava Runners, put them down to 7, and cast Risk Factor. But honestly, just doing this, taking these last two cards. Cancel. I don't know about modern play for Carnival Carnage. Okay, they just had double land. But that was still... Yeah, now they don't have the land for Demanding Dragon. Doing this before attacking because we could find a Lava Runner. Oh wow, they just took it? How were they just taking it? Alright, so they're playing Rekindling Phoenix also. Alright, let's get some Lava Coils in on the draw over the Pestilent Spirits, and probably just another one over Angrath. I do like Cannonade. I think I remember I brought in Cannonades last time actually in this matchup, and it was really good. Go to one coil. I guess we do need to kill Electrostatic Field and Rekindling Phoenix. One Daredevil, two Cannonade, two Coil. All right, game three. Oh, the Final Fantasy boss song led off the final boss fight. That's always the first one. Need another red mana source so we can shock and stage. More red mana. Perfect. Do I want to shock and stage immediately here? Then next turn I got to play both cards from light up the stage. So it's got to be like land. Yeah, let's just go and do it. It's got to be like land plus something that costs three or less. Perfect. Well, not necessarily perfect. We can't actually cast Carnival if they don't play a creature. Wow, thank you so much, opponent. Not only playing a creature, but playing a creature with one toughness. That is really kind of you. Dang, all right, well, we're clearing off lands off the top of the deck. So risk factor, I'd assume they're taking three for risk factor, and then shock, and then that was shock and Sovereign's Bite. That's kind of a bad sword point diplomacy for us, because those are like really good cards, but if they take the damage on all of them, you know, that is a lot of damage that comes pretty quickly. So they're letting us have the bite, which deals three and lets us gain three. So I really don't want to see my opponent play Demanding Dragon. As long as they're not Demanding Dragoning, we're going to be doing just fine. Another Lava Runner and a Skewer. All right, down to 11. And then our light at the stages are just hitting our land drops for us. But we're at 14 and they only have three cards in hand. So we're looking okay. No! Come on. Maybe that's a card I need in my sideboard. Man, what a good card. And that's lethal. So I could coil the fire, you know, I could have coiled the Firebrand before to kind of help us not die, but I think like the only way that we're really winning the next turn is if we are able to like risk factor there and try again. Man, demanding dragon, killing us both of those games. Usually you don't see, usually in mono red aggro, you don't see demanding dragon, but they had it, you know, game one, game three. That just killed us. Yeah, you're not usually that scared of that card, but you know, I mean, it's just not a card you see, like five mana cards, but it's really good. Really good against me. Overall though, 4-2, the deck felt really fun again. You know, it was good playing the deck. So sideboard wise, maybe Demanding Dragon would be a good card for us to have in the sideboard against decks that don't play a lot of creatures. Or, like, against Mono Red. This Eldest Reborn hasn't seemed like anything I've wanted at all. That Eldest Reborn can go. Maybe I'm supposed to be playing Demanding Dragon. Yeah, Lava Coil could be Bedevil. I think I like Lava Coil more, but... yeah, I'm going to put a Demanding Dragon in over that. Over that Eldest Reborn. Yeah, Pestilent Spirit wasn't as good for us this league. It certainly wasn't. You know, it was so good for us earlier, you know, in a different league, but this league wasn't so good. You know, we never had, like, you know, four mana, you know, like, usually turn, you know, what we're trying to do is, like, turn three, we have, like, our sword pointer or a risk factor or something like that, and then turn four, we have, like, Pestilent Spirit plus Burn Spell, like, Pestilent Spirit plus Carnival kill, like, their thing. No, Theater Horrors, I think, is just kind of too slow. Light of the Stage wasn't really that good for us. I was not very impressed with Light of the Stage. A lot of those, but... it's a card I'm not sure if we really need. Like, maybe I should be going down to 2 Light of the Stage and 4 Sword Point. Because Sword Point was very good. So I'm thinking maybe 2 light up, 4 sword point. I think I like that more. And then, yeah, I want to try the Pestilent Spirit one more time. It was definitely helpful against the Nexus deck that we had it out and, you know, got to attack a couple of times, got to deal 6. That was definitely helpful, but... I could see, you know, next time I play this, I'm going to still play Pestilent Spirit again, but I could see switching it up and not playing Pestilent Spirit at all. And then maybe go with like Lava Coils, Bedevils, things like that instead. But we'll see. You know, it could play the Viashina Pyromancer also is another card that's an option. But I'm going to try again with the Spirit the next time we play this. I think I still like it. So, there we go. Rakdos Burn. All right, if you're watching this later on YouTube, don't forget to hit that subscribe button, of course. And so how do we deal with the big creatures anyway? Sorry, this is usually what we do is we have Pestilent Spirit to deal with the big creatures. You know, we play this, then a Burn Spell. Yeah. So yeah, this is our card to deal with big creatures. Yeah, thanks for watching. I'll see you for the next video.